Everybody, we are here for one more life group. Here is Pastor Bruna, and today we will learn about the family of God. And I want to say that the children are part of the family of God. The Bible says in Ephesians 2:19 that you are a member of God's family. You know what does it mean? That means that you are part of the family of God because you are sons and daughter of God. If you receive Jesus in your heart, you became children of God. And that's amazing. So let's start. Now, I want you guys to open with your parents the Bible in Matthew 18, verse 12, 13, and 14. Let's read. The Bible says that if a man has 100 sheep and one of them wanders away, what will he do? Won't he leave the 99 others on the hills and go out to search for the one that is lost? And if he finds it, I tell you the truth, he will rejoice over it more than over the 99 that didn't wander away. In the same way, it is not my heavenly Father's will that even one of these little ones should perish. So I ask you, was Jesus really concerned about sheep? Why did Jesus tell his disciples this story about sheep that was lost? So let's find out. So first, sheep are part of the flock. Can you see here? Who knows what a flock is? A flock is a group of animals that live together as a family. Jesus told the story of a sheep which got separated from the flock. This flock was its family. Can you see? The shepherd is the man who takes care of the sheep. He noticed that one of them was missing. He counted the sheep, 99. I used to have 100. So he left the others and went looking for this lost sheep. It's not easy to find a lost sheep. Have you ever had to look for a lost pet? It's really hard. But look what happened. When the shepherd found the little sheep, he took it back to the other sheep. This little sheep was very important and it was part of the flock. The little sheep was really important. Do you have a family? Do you know that besides of belonging your family, you belong to God's family? You are part of God's family. And being part of God's family, you are so important to God. Even if you are a child, you are important to him. You are so important. So who is your family? Let's think about our family. What do we have? We have father, mother, brothers, grandparents, uncles, aunts. And all of us, we are related. But in God's family, how can we be members of the same family if you are not related? The Bible says that all who have received Jesus in their hearts are children of the Father, who is God. That is why the Bible affirms you are a member of God's family. Ephesians 2:19. Let's see what things our family and the family of God have in common. First one, we have a Father. Who is your father? In God's family, we have a father too. God is our father. Second thing, do families have siblings? Yes, some families have big siblings, some families small siblings. But in God's family, we also have these two. That's why in church we call adults, the people that are there, our brothers and sisters. It doesn't matter if they are adults or children, they are our brothers and sisters. The third thing, do family have children? Yes, many family do, and God's family has children too. Another thing, in the family, we take care of each other. You can see in your family, there is someone that takes care of you, that cooks, that buy the food, that prepares the food for you. If you are sick, someone gives you a medicine, takes care of you, take you to the shower, buy clothes for you. In our family, and in God's family, we take care of each other too. We take care of someone. When we do this, we demonstrate that we love them. In God's family, we also take care of each other. For example, in our Kids Life group, when you have a problem, when one of us have a problem, we pray for each other. We say good things to each other. This is taking care. There are many ways to take care of each other. For example, when you see that one of your friends is sad and you say, is everything gonna be okay? Or if you see that he is sick and you say, God, Jesus will heal you in the name of Jesus, you pray for them, you are taking care of them. Has anyone ever helped you doing something for you? It's another way to take care. If someone gives to you something that you need, for example, clothes or food, it's one taking care of another. Another thing is someone helping you say or doing things that are kind. Helping one another is a way of living in God's family. And we can do this. So let's do something nice to someone. We are not getting together as Kids Life group because of this situation, this virus. But we can do something to be kind to your family at home. You can do something kind to your mom today. You can do something to help her today. Let's do it. And now I want you to close your eyes, that we're going to pray. Father God, thank you because we are part of your family, because you are our Father. And as children, we are member of God's family. And we thank you because we know you can take care of us. And as children, as sons and daughters, we can take care of each other too. Please, God, help us to be used by you, taking care of our family, of God's family. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Family.
Of God's family.
Ephesians 2:19.
Ephesians 2:19.
See?
You are member.
God's family.
Ephesians 2:19.